Hey guys, I'm coming to you from my front porch again here, and I thought I'd show you another one of my cigar box guitars and take a closer look at it. This is the one I call my Delta Darlin guitar, and you'll see why here in a second. My dog's watching apparently. It's constructed a lot like my other guitars, but there is some unique differences. The tailpiece here is another kitchen cabinet hinge, just because I found out those are really durable and they work out really well. The bridge on this one is actually a tone-o-matic bridge, and it's just a floating bridge, so it's held down just by the string tension alone. And the tone-o-matic is basically what you'd find on a Gibson Les Paul, and it allows you to individually adjust the intonation of your strings, which is pretty nice. On the top here, you'll see I've got the star and bars painted on there, the symbol of the the U.S. Air Force. And then up here you'll see a P-51 Mustang, and it's flying through the clouds and everything. And this is all painted in acrylic paint and then sealed over. Down here you'll see I've kind of got some painted on rivets, kind of keeping with that airplane theme. And then I've got a closet pole socket that I used for the sound hole that's just been painted, it's painted white. And you'll see the volume knob here, and that's a Fender volume pot. And that's going back to here. And basically, there's two quarter-inch output jacks, and the reason being, this one has two internal piezo pickups, okay? And one is running just wide open and out to this first outlet, and then the other piezo pickup runs through the volume pot and then out, so you have some control over it. The reason I did that is because ideally when you have a piezo, because it's got it's a high impedance pickup, you really want to have a preamp before it goes out, but I didn't have that available, so I did what I could with what I had and ran one wide open, and then you can just adjust its level with your amplifier. And then the other one I ran through the volume pot just to experiment, and it gives you, some choices, basically. Also back here, you'll see I've got a conventional guitar strap, hanger. And then also you'll see that I've painted these bomb insignias across the back, just like they would have had on a World War II bomber, just trying to keep the theme going, And as we go around, you'll see, like here, I've got the name of my business in there, and I didn't really paint it, I just kind of embossed it in there so you could see it when you really look for it. On the top here, we've got a couple more of those kitchen cabinet hinges affixing the lid there, and in the chrome, just trying to keep the theme going here. And then the neck of the guitar once again is red oak, the fretboard rather, and the neck. The neck itself is I built by hand, and it's made of a few different pieces of red oak that were laminated together and then sanded and smoothed so you couldn't see where the various pieces were. And then the frets are made out of those little metal strips that come with your windshield wiper blades, and when you peel the rubber back you'll find those, and they're stainless steel. And I clipped them and rounded them with a grinding wheel and then leveled them all out how they needed to be so they wouldn't, buzz or anything. And they're real durable. They work out real good. Got some brass tacks. These are chrome, tacks for fret markers. And, I just pre-drill the holes a bit, add a little adhesive to the tack, and then finish putting it in. And I've never had one fall out, fall out of there yet. Up here for the nut, I've just got a standard bolt, and that holds the strings in place really well. And you'll see I've got a set of the Ping brand sealed tuners, which they're a quality tuner, very smooth, and they seem to hold their tune very well. And I've been real happy with those. The string tree you'll see there, I believe that's off a Fender Telecaster. This part right here, and that just helps to maintain the correct breakover angle on the nut here, because those two middle strings are a little longer from here forward just because of the distance to the tuners, and that makes sure that those strings don't move around on you, and then you get the correct tone that you're looking for. it worked out really well. And then you'll see I hand painted this you know, toothy mouth on here, and that's because if you've seen the old fighter planes, they would often have like a shark's mouth or a tiger mouth, something like that, and that's what I was kind of going for there. So just trying to keep with the theme. And then probably the most interesting part of the guitar is on the back, and that's this nose art that I painted on there, and I called her Delta Darlin because the name of my company is Delta Blues Classics, so I thought it made sense. And and tried to keep it in that same kind of World War II bomber girl theme, you know. And you can see the little banner says caution, and she's sitting on the bomb there and everything, if we can get it to focus. But anyway, you know, and it's not intended to be in like perfect realism or anything. It's just in that kind of, I don't know what you call it, folky, illustrative kind of style, like they would have painted on the planes, you know. And then you can see I painted on some more of the, you know, the simulated rivets there and everything, and just trying to keep the look going. But anyway, I think I'll go ahead and set this camera on the tripod here, if you bear with me, and I'll play it a little bit for you just so you can hear what it sounds like. And this time, just for something different, I'm going to play it acoustic so you can see that it does put out good sound without the amplifier. And just bear with me for a second here. Get this focused in good for you. And we'll give it a shot here.
Alright guys. It's tuned to an open G right now, you know, for easy slide play. But I mean, you can play it conventionally as well. Conventional style, you can also lay it across your lap like I sometimes do and play it like a lap steel, basically, you know, like a slide guitar. And we'll give that a shot. And some idea of the kind of sound it can put out. And you know, they're a lot of fun to build and they're a lot of fun to play. And anyway, I appreciate you guys watching these videos and commenting and everything. And believe me, I've got stacks more instruments to show you. So anyway, thanks for watching and I'll see you later. Bye.